you. We'll be starting off with location and place value. For instance, when you find your place yourself in a particular setting, that means it's your place. Just like we have four siblings and I happen to be the second sibling or the second born of my parents, it means my place in that family is two, which is my second, I'm in the second position. So that is the way numbers fall into place when it is mentioned that you have 10 billion. Or let's take for instance what you can always have in your savings. Maybe probably someone gave you 15,000. There is a place of 15,000 in numbers. Do you understand? Just like the way you all appear to be in a particular position in your family. So basically, we commonly have these place values, which we have the billion, we have the million, we have the thousand, we have the hundreds, we have the tens, and we have the eights. So in this way, I will be arranging them. This one is just one. The place of one, just on its own, is one unit. Now, when you add 0 to 1, it becomes tens. Just 1 0 addition. Now, when you add another 0 to 10, it becomes hundreds. Then when you add another 0, so it's in a progressive form, it's in this form, it's progressing upwards. So for every 0 addition makes the name to be different. So for this one, because over here, even right here, this is what we just have at the moment. Now, from this point, you can see that I don't need a 10 to add. I don't need just 2 0 or 1 for me to remain 1,000. Just 1,000. I just added only 1 0. When you add 0, it doesn't automatically climb to a million. If not, we would have said, you understand? It doesn't automatically progress to a million. Like we said, for each of these units, from one unit, you add a 0 and it makes it a 10. For hundreds, for you to achieve 100, you just have to add a 0 to tens. It becomes automatically hundreds. Get 1,000, we just have to add 0 to the 100 to get 1,000. But in the case of how did we now arrive at million, it's surprising. Now let's 1,000, a million, and a billion can be influenced by addition of either hundreds or tens. Let me repeat myself again. In order to achieve a unit, once you have just a number, if for instance I give you, you were just born in the family and your position happened to be one, you don't need to compare yourself with anybody. You're just one. You are just the only child. So in that instance, one standing on its own is a unit. It is just one unit. Now, for tens, for you to be able to achieve 10, what you just need to do is you just add a 0 to 10. It climbs from this point to tens. In order to achieve 100, you just need to add 0 to 10. It climbs up to 100. Are you seeing the direction? Now, for you to achieve just 1,000, you just add an extra 0. That 0 which you're adding here makes it 1,000. But you can't do that to go to a million. Do you understand? You can't do that.
skin that doesn't apply. It doesn't just climb from just an additional zero. Now, to influence these three units, happen to be the billion, the million, and the 2,000, you need to add either a 10 or a 100. What do I mean by a 10? A 10 is simply adding either one extra zero to make a 1,000, 10,000. Or you add 100 to make it 100,000. So in this case, this becomes 100,000. And this becomes 10,000. Do you understand? Now, from the highest point, remember that I said when I displayed those numbers, I showed you that a million has 6 zeros. Now, from this particular point, we can now move to a million, which means by addition of zero, like we were doing, we can achieve $1 million. You understand? And then we can also influence a million by either adding a 10 or a 100. Now let me show you. So in this instance, we already have a million right here. You understand? Already have a million right here. Now this million, like I said, these two things, these three things I marked as debits, can be influenced by a 10 or a 100. Now, for us to be able to achieve a million, what it means that we can either say 1 million. Instead of writing 1 million, we now say we add 10. You understand? So 10 and the normal 6 zeros that we have in a million. This is typically a million. So this is 10. So it means 10 million. Do you understand? Now when we add 100 to a typical million, this becomes 100 million. So also, for us to also, now that we have arrived at the highest, which happens to be 100 million, we can add another zero, because I said we can only influence a billion, a million, and a 1,000 by either a 10 and a 100. Now we have influenced million by the highest, which happens to be 100. You can influence them by the minimum, which is 10, and you can influence them by the maximum, which is 100. Now we have influenced this million to the highest limit, which happens to be 100 million. What I mean is, in the sense of additional zeros, you understand? Because we have 99 million. We have 99,999,999,999 million. Do you understand? So by influencing them, I'm referring to addition of zeros. Now we have influenced million, this million, by adding 100 to it. Now for us to now achieve a billion from a million, it has to be influenced on the rate of 100 million. Do you understand? Now we can only project million to billion by only influencing the 100 million by addition of another extra zero. Do you understand? We can't influence just a million to project it to a billion. And we cannot also influence 10 million to project it to a billion, because for every zero addition, it climbs in that way in units, in tens, in hundreds, in thousands, and so forth. So now, right here, we have achieved 100 million. So for us to achieve another, we have to influence those 100 million by adding an extra zero, which happens to be, this is the extra zero. Now, because there is nothing like 10,000, 10 hundred million, so all we do, we add to this zero that has a single there, and then write the remaining million. This becomes billion. Now, because I said initially that we can influence a billion, million, a thousand by either addition of tens or hundreds. Do you understand? Now we have gotten a billion. Influence this million, this billion. So by influencing this billion, we will just need to add 10 to the 9 zeros. So this happens to be billion 10. So what it simply means is 10 billion. Now to influence, if by 100, we just add 100 this is another million. Billion, we have 100. So the question we have here says, write in figures 720 billion 20,070. So how solve this math? We will take it step by step. In mathematics, you have to be fast and correct, just for you to know how to be conversant with speed. Now, that said, 700, now because what we look at, we look at the highest number, which usually starts with a sentence. Do you understand? What is the highest number we have a billion? Do you understand? So what we will do is we just put 000000. Now remember that a billion, always remember that a billion is 9 zeros. And a million is 6 zeros. A thousand is 100, is 3 zeros. And 100 is 2 zeros. And just tens is just 1 zero. And units is just on its own without any zero. Now, the question said 100. So we've captured the fact that the main caption is a billion. Do you understand? Now, what else is the highest? We have 100. So that means our notation will come in the form of 100 million, billion. You understand? It means that our notation will come in the form of 100 billion. So what we will simply do for the sake of solution, we'll just write 100 billion. Now, when we use this to form our base, this is 700. We write 700. So I'll let me just change this to a red ink so that you don't add them along when you're doing your summation. And it says the next one is 20 billion. So write 20. We're still maintaining our billion. Now, the question for the billion, you see this comma, what it means is that it has ended with the billion. We don't have any other number to add to the billion. Now, We didn't see anything like median. Of course, we should expect that billion is higher than median. So if, for instance, we decide to add million, we should also look out for it. But now, in notation, from the question, there was nothing addressing million. It skipped million, it skipped 100,000, it skipped, it now went 10,000, which happens to be 20,000. So you see that nothing actually here, we don't have anything in here. All we have here is 20,000. Remember that 20,000 is just, this is 8,000. And this is 20. We've answered this. And then we have 70. This is just 70. Do you understand? So what you would do as a math student, you would add this up to give you this in figures. You just bring down all the 0. You bring down the 7. You bring down the 0. Remember? There's nothing here, so let me just put this arrow so that you don't get. So make sure whenever you're writing your maths, write it in a straight line so that you don't get confused. It's very important. Do you understand? Try and write, make sure that your zeros maintain a straight line, because if you shift this 20 forward, it will be mistaken when you're summing it up. You can sum it up as 200,000. If you shift it further than that, the mistake keeps going. So make sure when you're writing something like this, as you're learning, try to ensure that you write it, I mean, each number will fill appropriately the number on top of it. So you just bring down the 0, you see, bring down the 7, there's nothing here. You bring down the 0, follow the marks too, the commas. There's nothing here, bring down the 0. Here, there is 2. Here, there is nothing. Here, there is nothing. There is nothing. There is nothing. Here, there is nothing. You have 2 and you have 7. So what we actually have here, this in figures, simply is 720 billion. Remember I said there was no 100 million, there was no 10 million, there was no million itself. So went ahead, all right, so this is the answer. Hope is not confusing. Just take your time and look at it. So let's go to the next problem. So our second question says 805,004,400. This is the second question. Looking at this question, I believe you can answer it with the first example we just did. Now, the same way, we'll just do it like that. I think with practice, it will be faster. Now, when you're looking at this, you would find that in billion, in million, in thousand, in the hundred, in tens, and in units, what's the highest? You have 1 million. So we've looked clearly, there was no billion, so we can find 1 million. Do you understand? So that means 1 million is going to be the notation where every other thing is going to be based on. Do you understand? Now let us write something. 1 million has 6 zeros, do not forget. Now, we paused because this million has some numbers on it. And what's the number? The number is 805. Wow! 805. So what it means, we have 100 influencing our million. Kingston, so we would put cornbread. So our notation will be in this form. So we have to place the figures. You understand? So placing the figures means that this is 800. 800 in 5. We're going faster now. I didn't put 5 on his own because it's 5 million. Of course, yes. It's gonna be 5 million. Let's say 800 million. 5 million. You know, these two numbers are under million. So you can just put it 800 by 5 million. Do you understand? So, because we are now high students, like we're proceeding higher and we need to make our accuracy or our speed to be increased as well. So you can see that this one is 805 million. Now the next one is 4,000 and 4,000. So we just cross. 4,000 is just 3 zeros. 1,000 is 3 zeros. So we say 4. That's what this means. Now we have 400. Now 100 is just 2 zeros. We have 4. It says 400. Now we just remember I said, okay, if you look at my solving, you will see that the zeros align. You would see that this is this. This is this. I'm just bringing it down so that you don't get confused. You understand? So we have 0. We have 0. You see? Straight up. Straight up. This is 4. Straight up is 4. Straight up. 0. Straight up. Maintain the commas. Straight up. So we have started from here. You understand? So this is 805,004,400. Hope it's clear. What do we have here? The question says write in words. Of course, we have handled the ones of figures. You understand, writing them in figures, but right now we are going to be doing them in words. Yes, of course, when you start cashing out some little money, maybe your mom gives you pocket money and then asks you to write it down for me, you can easily write them down. So that's why it's very important. And of course, this particular numbers are quite large, and the large ones are very confusing in exams. You understand? Of course, if you see 13,000, you can probably see 13,000, of course. And there are some levels where you have them thinking of primary 4, primary 5, and then about, but as primary 6, it's high class. Like, we're going forward to high school, and then we need to know high things, you understand? So that's why we're doing the hardest ones. So, just looking at this, it's quite huge, and it's confusing, because I usually put marks, commas on them so that it could tell me how many zeros are there now, how many zeros. But right now, it's just, this is how it appeared in the question. Honestly, this is how it appeared. So I wanted to influence it by adding commas, but I was like, how did you happen to see it in this form? You don't have to get confused. Do you understand? So what you happen to do is, the commas are usually placed for every 3 zeros. You understand? Let me repeat myself. Any comma you see, especially when the numbers are large, you do it in space of 3 zeros. And then whatever that is left at the end, you start from the ending to this point. To this point. You don't start from here to put your commas. Of course, you will get it wrong. Some, in some cases, except you are so familiar with these things. but for someone who is getting used to these things, you have to put the commas. I prefer you putting the commas on your math solutions because it helps you to do your math fast. You understand? It helps you to rule out errors. It's very important. It's very, very important, especially when they say write in words. Whichever form you're doing it, so it helps you. It eases you a lot of stress. Even sometimes when you start getting used to solutions like this, you just have to put the commas right there in your head, especially when you're doing offhand calculation. You understand? You just have to put those commas there so that it doesn't fault you. Right to the left. You don't start from the left to put your commas. So you start to put your commas for every three zeros. Now, if I assume that this is a zero, so you see, 1, 2, 3, you put a comma. 1, 2, 3, you put a comma. 1, 2, 3, the comma. Now this is what is left. Do you understand? It tells you that we had 3 zeros here, 3 zeros here, and 3 zeros here. This is 3 zeros, 3 zeros. This is 3 zeros. Do you understand? We have 3 zeros here, 3 zeros here, and 3 zeros here. Do you understand? So we already have a sum of 9 zeros, which gives us billion. Of course, do not forget that. Just this represents a billion. You understand? So this first zero. This first zero just goes to this particular point. This other zero goes here. And this other zero goes there. So this is what it actually means. But because we have passed the stage, so if you not understand, can you review those videos again so that you would understand? Take it step by step. It's not something you would understand just once if you are, depending on how much your speed is in studying. But you can always replay them, they're always there for you to watch. So, kindly look at them again and again and then get yourself familiarized to it. So, now we have identified that there is a billion. Wow. Now, remember, this billion was not influenced by 1, 2. And this 1, 2 represents 100. Do you understand? That is how we reach this 100 point. So, but that's not what we're looking at. So what it simply means is that we have 404. It's necessary that you put commas in your figures because it helps to distinguish which particular notation you are going to be working with. Now, for instance, as it is right now, for someone who is not used to writing in words, the person will be confused or see the exercise as very difficult. But when you put them in commas, it helps to break down the question for you. Okay, now how do you put the commas? You put the commas from the right to the left. You don't start from this end. On no account should you start from this end. It is a no. You only start from this point to put your commas. Now, when I say put your commas, you would count every 3 zeros. You don't count 2 zeros, you don't count 1 zero. You would count every 3 zeros. Now let's do it. So we will count 1, 2, and 3. You put a comma. Another 1, 2, and 3. Another comma. You count 1, 2, and 3. You put another one. You understand? This is what it means. Had it been started from here, we would have ended up getting the wrong notation.
But because we started from that end, whatever that is left here, we leave it like that because it's not up to 3-0. Like I said, count for everything 0. We just have to leave it like that. Now, what this means that we have 3 zeros here, we have 3 zeros here, and we have 3 zeros here. So what this means is that we have 3 zeros here, we have 3 zeros here, and we have 3 zeros here. Now, remember what I told you when we did the introduction? We said that for every 3 zeros is 1,000. For every 6 zeros is 1,000,000, and for every 9 zeros is 1,000,000,000. You understand? Now, looking at this question, we have identified there is 3 zeros in 3 places. Do you understand? That means 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. So we have 1,000,000,000. Do you understand? Which signifies 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. 0,000,000. This is 1,000,000,000. Do you understand? Now, when you look at this, you only find 1, 2, which signifies 100, because 100 is just a 0 to a 10. So this is just 2 zeros, which means 100. So we have 100,000,000,000 as our highest notation. This becomes 100,000,000,000 is the highest notation. Do you understand? So we would place these values in the order of our highest notation. So, now, because we have identified that there is 100,000,000,000, so this means this will take the place of 449,000,000,000. It has covered the whole of this. Do you understand? Now, there's nothing here. Now, we'll pick this other one. This one is simply, you can see the arrow. Just so be mindful of the arrow when you are looking at it so that it doesn't confuse you. You understand? This is, because this is 3 zeros, is not up to, because this number is standing on its own. It's not, just like the one we have 100, we add this calculation. You understand? So this is 210,000. Here's what it means. Now, the remaining one here is simply 73. Do you understand? So, we're going to add these words together, which means 149,000,000,000. Now, you would ask me, where do we need, if you were able to put the commas in the figures, you wouldn't be looking for where to put the commas in the words. You understand what I mean? Now, because we have already identified the commas, you just put the commas where you have identified, just the way you're adding them. You put the comma, you add 200
10,070. You could see that we were not looking for where to buy the commas from or where to borrow them from. We had already fixed them in the numbers, in the figure. We have just fixed them in the figure. So when we arise and when you're trying to sum them up, we just have to just place them as it appeared in the figures. So just for you to be sure that you are in the right track, is when you have placed the commas right in the figures, you'll be able to carefully place them the same way you have placed them in the figures in your words. Now, this is the second question in the write in words form. This is the second question we are addressing. In the second question, this is what we have. 1701491. We are asked to write these figures in words. So, I won't be explaining like I did in the first problem, because I had explained them. So I will just try to put those things that I explained in the first problem together so that you will be able to pair them up. Now, I told you that you always add your commas starting from the right hand side. You understand? So now, for every 3 zeros, you add a comma. This is 1, 2, 3. This is a comma. 1, 2, 3, this is a comma. That's it. You understand? Leaving us with a 10, which means this resembles 10. Remember, this is 3, 0. It's just 3, 0. So, which means this signifies a million and a 10. So, this is tens. Millions in tens. Now we're going to be finding the actual words that represents this question. Now the first is 17. Remember, it's tens. 17 million. This goes to represent this. Then for this, we have 10,000. 10,000. And for this, we have 491. Do you understand? So we'll be summing them all together. Now, this means 17. Remember the comma. 10,000.